Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Journey to the Kingdom of Water Dragons. Chapter 1. The Fisher's Voyage. Eliot, a fisherman from the small coastal village of Windward, had always been captivated by the sea and the tales it held. His grandfather, a seasoned sailor, had often spoken of a hidden world beneath the waves, a realm where majestic creatures known as water dragons reigned supreme. These stories, dismissed by many as old sailors' tales, ignited Eliot's imagination and fueled his desire for adventure. One day, Eliot decided to embark on a journey to uncover the truth behind these legends. He prepared his modest fishing boat, the Sea Whisperer, for the voyage. As he set sail, the familiar coastline of Windward faded into the horizon, and a sense of anticipation filled the air. The sea was a vast, ever-changing expanse. Eliot navigated through calm waters and raging storms, under starlit skies and over mysterious, deep blue depths. Days turned into nights and back into days, as time seemed to blur in the endless ocean. As Eliot ventured further from familiar waters, he encountered phenomena that defied explanation. The sea currents moved in strange patterns, forming whirlpools that seemed to beckon in towards a specific direction. Bioluminescent creatures, unlike any he had seen before, illuminated the waters with their ethereal glow, guiding his path. One night, under a canopy of stars, Eliot's boat was enveloped in a thick, mystical fog. The air was filled with an eerie, melodious hum, and the water around him glowed with a surreal, phosphorescent light. It was then that Eliot realized he had entered the realm of the water dragons. As the fog lifted, Eliot beheld a sight that took his breath away, a colossal gateway rising from the depths of the ocean. Intricately carved with ancient symbols and guarded by statues of dragons, the gateway marked the entrance to the underwater kingdom. With a mixture of awe and trepidation, Eliot sailed through the gateway. The world around him transformed, the sea became clearer, the colors more vivid, and the marine life around him more exotic and abundant. He saw shadows of colossal creatures in the distance, moving gracefully through the water. As Eliot delved deeper, he came upon the underwater city, a marvel of architecture that seemed to defy the laws of nature. Towers and spires made of coral and pearl spiraled towards the ocean's surface, shimmering in the underwater light. Schools of brightly colored fish swam through the streets, and plants swayed gently in the current. But the most awe-inspiring sight was the water dragons themselves. Majestic and powerful, they soared through the water with an elegance that belied their size. Their scales shimmered in hues of blue and green, and their eyes held a wisdom that spoke of ancient times. Eliot anchored his boat at a safe distance and observed the dragons. He saw them engage in what appeared to be a ritualistic dance, creating intricate patterns in the water. Their movements were fluid and harmonious, a display of their mastery over their domain. As night fell, the underwater city glowed with a magical light, and the dragons retreated into the depths of their kingdom. Eliot lay on the deck of his boat, his mind racing with the day's incredible events. He realized that his journey had just begun, and that he was about to uncover secrets that had been hidden beneath the waves for centuries. The chapter concludes with Eliot's resolve to explore the kingdom further and learn about the water dragons. He knew that his journey would be fraught with dangers and challenges, but his curiosity and desire for discovery propelled him forward. The sea, with its mysteries and legends, had always called to him, and now he was ready to answer. Chapter 2: The Underwater Kingdom. As dawn broke, Eliot prepared to delve deeper into the mysterious underwater kingdom he had glimpsed the night before. He donned his diving gear, equipped with lights and cameras to document this unprecedented exploration. With a deep breath, he plunged into the crystal-clear waters and swam towards the majestic city. The city was a spectacle of underwater architecture, with buildings crafted from coral, pearl, and stones that glowed with an inner light. Schools of vibrantly colored fish darted between the structures, and strange, beautiful plants swayed in the gentle currents. Eliot was particularly captivated by a grand palace at the city's center, adorned with sculptures of dragons and mythical sea creatures. As he approached, he noticed the water dragons, enormous, elegant beings, their scales shimmering like jewels. They moved with a grace that belied their size, and their eyes conveyed a deep intelligence. He observed the dragons from a distance, noting their interactions. They seemed to communicate through a series of intricate gestures and sounds, creating a mesmerizing underwater ballet. Eliot realized that these creatures were not just the rulers of this realm, they were its guardians, protecting the delicate balance of their underwater world. As Eliot explored further, he discovered a series of murals depicting the history of the water dragons and their kingdom. The murals showed the dragons in harmony with the sea, alongside human-like figures who seemed to live and work with them. This hinted at an ancient bond between humans and dragons, a relationship built on mutual respect and understanding. But the peace of the kingdom was not unchallenged. Eliot came across a series of damaged murals and signs of struggle. It appeared that the kingdom had faced threats, both from within and beyond its borders. The dragons' role as protectors was more than ceremonial. They were warriors, defending their realm against unseen adversaries. Eliot's presence did not go unnoticed. A group of water dragons approached him, their demeanor cautious but not hostile. Through a series of gestures, one dragon seemed to communicate with Eliot, leading him to a secluded part of the city. There, he was shown a hidden chamber filled with ancient artifacts and scrolls. The chamber contained records of the kingdom's history, including interactions with the surface world. Eliot learned of past alliances and conflicts, of times when the underwater kingdom had come to the aid of humans and vice versa. The scrolls spoke of a pact made long ago, a promise of mutual aid and protection. However, the pact had been broken, leading to a period of isolation for the kingdom. The water dragons have retreated from the world above, guarding their secrets and nursing a sense of betrayal. Eliot realized that his arrival might be seen as an opportunity or a threat, depending on how he approached this delicate situation. The chapter concludes with Eliot returning to the surface, his mind racing with the day's discoveries. He understood that the kingdom was not just a place of wonder, but also a realm with its own struggles and politics. Eliot knew that if he were to learn more and perhaps help reforge the ancient bond between humans and water dragons, he would need to tread carefully, respecting the customs and wishes of the kingdom's inhabitants. Chapter 3. Between Two Worlds. Eliot, having spent several days exploring the underwater kingdom and interacting with its majestic inhabitants, began to understand the complex dynamics of this hidden world. The water dragons, graceful and wise, had accepted his presence with a cautious curiosity, and through a series of interactions, Eliot had started to learn their ways and customs. He discovered that the water dragons were not only guardians of the sea, but also keepers of ancient knowledge and lore. They possessed a deep understanding of the ocean's mysteries and had lived in harmony with its creatures for centuries. The dragons shared tales of their ancestors, great sea serpents who had roamed the world's oceans in ancient times, and spoke of their connection to the elemental forces of water. The kingdom itself was a marvel of underwater engineering, with structures built to withstand the pressures of the deep sea and harness the power of ocean currents. Eliot was particularly fascinated by a grand library, where scrolls and tomes written in an ancient script were preserved in watertight casings. With the help of a friendly dragon, he began to decipher these texts, uncovering stories of alliances and conflicts with surface dwellers. However, Eliot also learned of a growing threat to the kingdom. A rival faction of sea creatures, embittered by past conflicts and driven by a desire for power, had been stirring unrest in the deeper trenches. These creatures, once allies of the water dragons, had turned against them, seeking to claim the kingdom's treasures and knowledge for themselves. As tensions in the underwater realm escalated, Eliot found himself in a unique position. The water dragons, recognizing his genuine interest and respect for their culture, sought his counsel. They hoped that Eliot, with his perspective as a human and an outsider, could offer insights into resolving the brewing conflict peacefully. Eliot embarked on a diplomatic mission, venturing into the darker, more perilous parts of the ocean to meet with the leaders of the rival faction. Accompanied by a contingent of water dragons, he navigated through treacherous waters, encountering strange and fearsome sea creatures along the way. In a cavern lit by bioluminescent corals, Eliot met with the leaders of the rival faction. The meeting was tense, with mistrust on both sides. Eliot listened to their grievances, understanding that the conflict stemmed from a complex web of historical betrayals and misunderstandings. He proposed a council of peace, where leaders from both sides could come together to discuss their issues and find a path forward. The rival faction, though skeptical, agreed to the council, intrigued by Eliot's neutral stance and genuine desire for harmony. Eliot returned to the water dragons with this news, and preparations for the council began. The chapter concludes with Eliot reflecting on his role in bridging the worlds of humans and water dragons. He realized that his journey had transformed from a quest for adventure into a mission of diplomacy and peacekeeping. The fate of the underwater kingdom and the resolution of an ancient conflict now hinged on the success of the upcoming council. Chapter 4. The Fisher's Destiny. The day of the council had arrived, and Eliot, accompanied by representatives of the water dragons, made his way to the agreed-upon meeting place, a neutral zone in the vast underwater expanse. The atmosphere was tense, with both sides eyeing each other warily. Eliot felt the weight of responsibility on his shoulders. The peace of an entire kingdom rested in the balance. The council commenced with leaders from both factions presenting their grievances. The rival faction, led by a formidable sea creature named Vortigern, voiced their feelings of betrayal and exclusion, accusing the water dragons of hoarding knowledge and power. The water dragons, in turn, spoke of past alliances broken and the need for trust and cooperation to maintain the balance of the ocean. Eliot listened intently, understanding that centuries of conflict and misunderstanding had led to this moment. He spoke eloquently of the need for unity, drawing on the history and lore he had learned during his time in the kingdom. He proposed a treaty that would allow for shared guardianship of the ocean's resources and a council that would convene regularly to address any disputes. The negotiations were long and arduous, with both sides making concessions and agreements. Eliot's unbiased perspective and genuine respect for both parties helped bridge the divide, and slowly, a framework for peace began to take shape. As the council drew to a close, Vortigern, impressed by Eliot's diplomacy, presented a gift, a small, luminous pearl. This pearl, Vortigern explained, was a symbol of the deep sea, a token of the newfound peace between the factions. With the treaty agreed upon, the council concluded in a ceremonial exchange of promises. The underwater kingdom and its once rival faction had embarked on a new path, one of mutual respect and cooperation. Finally, Eliot returned to the surface world, the luminous pearl in hand. He had come to the kingdom seeking adventure, but had found much more. A deeper understanding of the ocean's mysteries and his role in bridging two worlds. As Eliot sailed back to his coastal village, he reflected on his incredible journey. He had witnessed the wonders of the underwater kingdom, brokered peace between ancient rivals, and forged friendships with the majestic water dragons. His tale, he knew, would become part of the village's lore, a story passed down through generations. Eliot's adventure had changed him. He was no longer just a fisherman, he was a guardian of a secret pact, a bridge between the human world and the mysterious realm of the water dragons. As the shores of Windward came into view, Eliot smiled, knowing that the ocean would always call to him, its depths holding more secrets and adventures yet to be discovered.